Hey guys, Dhananjay here, and in this video I am going to review the Nubia Z9 Mini, which apparently has one of the best camera experiences that I ever had, but one of the worst software experiences too. So before further ado, let's get into the review. So let's start with the build quality, and I have to say that the build quality is like very good. As you can see, the front is covered with Gorilla Glass and the back seems to be a glass, but it's not glass actually, it's a removable back which is made of plastic. As you can see, this is plastic and it's completely removable. And as we open the back cover, you will be able to see that this is the memory card slot over here and the SIM card slot is over here at the side. It accepts only nano SIM, so you have to take care of that. And both the SIM cards go into the same slot, and if we open this up, there are two SIM slots over there. And this is the camera, and the back seems pretty good, and attaching the back panel once again is quite hectic. And there is a scratch guard on the phone in the box only, so you don't have to worry about attaching the scratch guard once again. But as it has Gorilla Glass 3, I may not worry about the scratches, because Gorilla Glass 3 do not get scratches that easily. And when it comes to back panel, as you can see, I got some scratches over here. I'll say that it was quite rough use, so I got some scratches. So I will suggest you guys to take care of that, because getting scratches is not a good thing. And I did not expect the scratches to come so easily, but they are there, so yeah, I told you guys that. And as you can see, the side of the phone looks to be covered with metal. At least it gives a metallic finish to the phone, but it's not metal, it's hard plastic. And as I said in my initial impressions too, the USB port over here looks very cool with the real metal over here. And this is the bottom speaker, which can be covered very easily, and if we cover this speaker, then there is no sound that can come out of the phone. So that's a bad thing for the phone, but it can be adjusted. This is the microphone over here, and here is the noise cancellation mic at the top, and this is the 3.5mm headphone jack, and the sound quality through the 3.5mm headphone jack is like very good, and the sound quality through the speaker is also very good. And now let's talk about one of the most interesting factor about the phone, and that's the camera. And I have to say that it is one of the best camera that I have used. OnePlus One is obviously very near, but I may give my vote to Nubia Z9 Mini for the options that it has. I'll show you guys. So before I show you guys the sample pictures that I have taken with the phone, let's go into the pro mode. And as you can see, now we can control almost everything. Like, we can control the focus from here, we can control the ISO, the white balance can be controlled from here too. And then one of the most interesting thing, that's the shutter speed, that can be controlled from the phone only. Surely a plus point. And exposure can be adjusted too. Like, if I want it to look very dark, then I can select low exposure, and if I want it to be very bright, then I can select high exposure. I'll cover more of these in my full camera review, so don't forget to hit the subscribe button for that. And as you can see in the sample pictures, the photos taken with the phone are like very, very good, no issues whatsoever. And if you use the pro mode, and if you know how to use the shutter speed, ISO and everything else, then the photos captured with the phone are really awesome, and the effect that it gets is really cool. And I have to say that I am not a good photographer, still I got so much good pictures, according to me at least. But if you are a pro photographer, and if you know all the options, then this phone will surely click awesome pictures. And the front facing camera is also very good. The front facing camera is actually 8 megapixel shooter, and the 8 megapixel shooter is just awesome, and this is the best front facing camera I have ever used. Not even the OnePlus One's front camera is that good. And if you are a girl watching this video and you want a selfie camera, or you want a front facing camera which is very, very good and which will make you look very good, then this is the phone you should get, because the photos taken are really awesome. And I could not resist myself to take photos, because I do not take selfies that much and I do not like to take selfies a lot. So guys, that was it for the camera department, and I'll give 9.5 out of 10 for the camera department on the phone. So let's talk about the display and the sound quality of the phone, and let's play a video. And actually, this is a 2560p video, and as you can see, the display looks very good, and the sound quality testing will also be done, so you can hear the sound and the display will be shown to you too. As you can see, the view angles are also very good. And the screen is a bit reflective, but that's nothing to worry about because it's not as much reflective as many other phones are. So no issues whatsoever with the display quality, and the display looks very good in the bright sunlight too because of the highest brightness that's possible is like very good. As you can see, if I increase the brightness to the fullest, it's very very bright, so no issues with that. And the front display is 5 inch and it's 1080p. So obviously it has to be a very good display. And as you heard, the sound output through the speakers over here is very good. And I like to add that whenever I used to get ready for the college every morning, then I used to play songs on the phone with the speaker, and the speaker is very loud, so no issues with the loudness of the speaker, and it's very clear too. So thumbs up for the sound quality and the display quality on the phone. So these are some of the facts that I loved about the Nubia Z9 Mini. And now let's talk about the software on the phone. And the software on the phone is like very very bad, as you can see. Let me just lock the phone. If I now unlock the phone, it takes 1 or 2 seconds to unlock the phone, and that's quite frustrating for me. And one more thing, if I just slide from here, it will open up the camera from here. And if I just slide from, yeah, as you can see, it opened up the camera. So, and if I just swipe from here, then it will open the dial pad, and that's quite annoying because if we slide from here, it should open the dial pad, but it doesn't open that. So let it be, and let's jump into settings, and let me show you guys. It's running 5.0.2, and the settings are stripped down. Like if you have custom skin on the Android, then it's like there are many more options in the settings, but in the Nubia UI, there are less options compared to the stock settings menu on the Nexus devices. So that's a good thing too, and that's a bad thing too. And if we just go into feature, you'll be able to see that we can select many things from here. Like if we select profile, then we can select, if the phone is in pocket, select this mode, one-handed operation mode. Let me show you the one-handed operation mode. If I just turn it on, and now if I want to use the one-handed operation mode, then just tilt the phone a little bit, and as you can see, it's the one-handed operation mode. And you can do everything from here too. And this was it for the one-handed operation mode, and we can even use the power save mode. And I have to say that this surely saved a lot of juice for me, because whenever I used to go below 40% on the battery, then I used to turn this on, then I used to select all these options like restrict CPUs, and all the data connections were turned off, and it surely saved a lot of amount of juice for me. So this power save mode and the 100 operation mode surely works very fine. And if we go into smart face, then it just like smart leather switcher. Like if you have a flip cover, then if you just put the flip cover on, the screen will be turned off automatically. It's like that. And if we go into touch gestures, you'll be able to see that from here we can select the double tap to unlock feature, like this, it will unlock the phone. And there are many other options too, which I did not use that much. And one more interesting thing is that there is palm screen lock. Like if I just do like this, it doesn't work always. I don't know why it's not working, but as you can see, as I said, the software is not that good, so it's not working right now. But the palm screen lock works. Like if you just put your hand on the top of the phone is locked. So as you saw, the software is not that good. There are features which will be very good, and this is smart sensing. I did not use this too, but there are many options. You can use these options, like if you just shake to change the song. You can simply shake the phone and the song will be changed. So that's surely a nice thing. Go back and let me just show you one more thing. And that's the split screen. So this is the split screen. Like I have opened Play Store in one application, and let's open Music Player in another. I have to say that this ate a lot of amount of battery for me. So as you can see, it's not well oriented, and different stories are coming on each other. So as you can see, the split screen is obviously a very good feature to have, but it's not in that great condition. So I won't say that it's like very good, or you can use the split screen anytime you want. It's not as good as the multi-window feature on the Samsung phones, but it's surely good to have the feature on the phone. And guys, when I talk about the performance, I mean to say that overall UI doesn't feel that smooth. Like the UI or the software present on the Nubia Z9 Mini is not that well polished. I'll say that the Moto E second generation, which is priced almost half or more than half, has a better polished software on it. And the Nubia Z9 Mini priced at 17,000 rupees, that's quite much for the phone, and software experience is not that good. By this, I don't mean that the apps don't open and close very fast or the apps do not run smoothly. Apps run smoothly and everything runs fine, but the overall UI is a little bit laggy, or you can say it's not that well polished. And obviously these issues can be fixed with the software update. And it's been a month or around a month since the Nubia Z9 Mini is launched in India, and there is no software update as of now. And I hope that Nubia releases some software update for that, and it can be fixed with the software update. And one of the problems that I had with the phone is that as soon as I unboxed the phone and I started using the phone, but after that I felt that the phone was really really laggy and the phone wasn't performing that well. So after that I had to factory reset the phone, and after factory resetting the phone worked good. I won't say that it was at its best, because with the Snapdragon 615 and 2GB of RAM, it should work fine, or it should run through the applications. Actually it opens and closes the application very fast, there is no issue with that, but the overall UI feels very laggy and the UI is not that great. So I would have preferred a smoother UI, and if these options are not present but the UI is very smooth, then I would have preferred that anytime. I'll give 5 out of 10 marks for the software on the phone, and it was like very bad experience because the software doesn't feel that fast or that optimized for the phone. It might be because the 615 chipset, as you guys know, that it gets heated up very easily. So they might have underclocked the CPU, or it might be on power save mode always or something like that, because the phone, even after having the Snapdragon 615, does not heat up. Like, I have to say that it does not heat up. Even after I watched videos for 1 hour or 1.5 hour, the phone did not heat up like crazy. It's just a very minor warming, and that's nothing to worry about. So thumbs up to Nubia or ZTE for having the 615 chipset and still the phone does not heat up. And so Xiaomi and HTC, like Xiaomi Mi 4i and the HTC Desire 820, should learn some lessons from Nubia, because even after having the 615 chipset, if Nubia does not heat up, then the second generation Mi 4i should not heat up, obviously. So I'm pretty much sure that the software was scaled down, or as I said earlier, it might be running on power save mode or conservative mode always to reduce the heating issue on the phone. So after this, now let's talk about the battery life. And the battery life is like very good on the phone. It will surely get you through the day with moderate to heavy use. If your usage is very heavy, then you might not get through a day, but for medium users or medium to high users, you will get 4 hours to 4.5 hours of screen on time very easily. So no issues with the battery life too. And let's talk about the gaming on the device. And I have to say that the gaming on the device is also very good. There were no major hiccups. As I said, the apps open and close on the phone very fast. There are no issues with that. But the overall UI lag is there, which is like very irritating for me. So as you can see, I have just upgraded to Town Hall level 8. And I'm quite addicted to Clash of Clans, but now I'm getting rid of the Clash of Clans. So after upgrading to Town Hall 8, I might not play that much, and I just attacked once and I had 3 stars too. And if you are interested in my clan name, then here it is. As you can see, this is the clan name, in case if you wanna join, because last time I showed this, people were like, tell me your clan name and all. And I am full on my resources too, just that I need a little bit of gold so that I can upgrade immediately after I get to Town Hall level 8. So basically the gaming on the device is very good, so no issues with the gaming, because the phone does not heat up that much too. Like, at least it doesn't heat up as much as the Eureka with 615 chipset would heat up. So thumbs up to Nubia for doing something with the software so that the phone doesn't heat up. So guys, to sum up the review, I would say that Nubia Z9 Mini surely packs a beautiful display, awesome sound quality, an amazingly amazing camera, a very good camera rather, but the software experience is like very very bad. And the price point, which I'll talk about now, is one of the things which you should consider before buying the phone. So the Nubia Z9 Mini is priced at 17,000, and if you increase your budget by 1,000 or 2,000, you can get Mi 4 or the OnePlus One 16GB variant. And after having both these options at the same price range, I think that the software experience purely kills the device, because after having an amazing display, as I said, amazing display, sound quality and all those things, the software experience being so bad is not at all good, and I did not like the software experience on the phone. And if Nubia fixes these issues, then I'll surely add that in the description below. So if you are watching this video after 6 months or 1 year,
do check the description below. And I would have surely preferred the phone if it would have been priced around 13,000 or 14,000. Because when I bought Mi3 at 14,000, it had Snapdragon 801 actually, but it doesn't have 4G LTE, so it was named Snapdragon 800. And the Nubia Z9e priced at 17,000 has only 615. Rather Snapdragon 615. So that's a concern for me, but money is not your point of view. But if you want a purely great camera experience, then surely go for Nubia Z9 Mini. And I hope this video helped you to decide whether to buy Nubia Z9 Mini or not to buy. And this is it for this video, guys. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to hit the like button if you like this video. And if you have any suggestions, queries or anything related to Nubia Z9 Mini, do let me know about that in the comment section below. And don't forget to check the channel, because there are many such amazing content on the channel and you'll surely love it. So thank you guys, thank you for watching.